Hello, and welcome back to a Game of Thrones mod for Crusader Kings 2. So, we have another couple of custom courtiers before we get into anything else. We have Barristan. Barristan is a well-traveled lowborn who has come from the north and decided to join our court. He looks for some kind of fame and glory, perhaps? We'll find out. We have Trentos, nicknamed Crook. He used to steal a lot and was eventually taken in by a merchant who caught him, and he taught him how to get money more easily in other means. Through careful changing of numbers in books and things like that, you could get a little bit extra off the top. He's been doing that ever since, and he has come to our court to do some of the same stuff. Right, so... last time, we had a couple of children. We had Arwen and we had Frenya. Oh, one other thing I completely forgot. We also have, if I go along here, one of these. Yes, Aegor. I have renamed the dynasty because I remember to do it. He is now Aegor Ironweaver. There we go. Because Rivers was a silly name anyway, because he was a bastard dynasty. Well, I mean, it would have been fine if I had given him a bastard house anyway. Long story short, he now has an actual house name, and we can move on with that and not get confused by multiple rivers. Right. We need to pick an ambition and a character focus. Our ambition. What do we want? What do we want? Well, we're slothful, we're greedy, gluttonous, arbitrary. I don't know. Maybe money? We could build a... well, that's a war chest for going to war. That's not exactly what we want. Valyrian sword, perhaps we would want that. And many children is definitely one we could just take. Fall in love, I don't know. How? Yeah, it's either sword or it's children. I mean, we'll take the children one because that's one that we're likely to like. We're already halfway there, so we might as well take that right now, and then we can take the other one later. Pick character focus. I don't know. If our focus was that many children, you would think maybe family, but we're also like gluttonous, greedy. I don't know, maybe business if we're greedy? We're not really business focused. We're not really anything focused. We're actually pretty dumb. Yeah. I don't know, maybe family? It's not perfect. I don't think there's a great fit for us. Maybe business would be fine. I mean, it might be, like, slothful just makes me think we're not going to do anything, but, I don't know, how about we just kind of, like, we're kind of into business, but not really, you know, it's just something that we like because we get money out of it and it helps us pay for food and clothes. Yeah, okay. We need some sworn shields because our previous bodyguard was murdered. Let's choose some. Aegor seems like a good choice. And was that our husband was the other one? Yeah, our husband also seems like a good choice. There we go. Nothing really else to do here. Right, drowned man, no, go on a reaving. I don't think we would go on a reaving, like right now. Maybe we would. I don't know. Maybe we'll wait till we're just a little bit older, and then we'll go on a reaving. Yeah. We'll wait till... Maybe we're 20 and we'll go on a reaving. There we go. We had poor military ruler happen to us. Oh, we can also now set our husband as our regent because we don't have a regent. There we go. He already has an honorary title? What's his current... oh, he's bodyguard, yeah. We'll have him designated regent. Cool. My lady, it's because of my attention. Nobody's been designated... I'm sorry, maester. We just beat you to it like seconds ago. We did that, right? Yeah. King Mern the Hunter revoked the High Lordship of Golden Grove from Lord Victor of Golden Grove. Okay, cool. A son was born to Justin Benson and Roel Kenning named Rogar. Rogar Benson. Cool. Let's have a look at how some of these wars are going as well. Aegon, you are very much losing your war against the Stormlands. The Ironlander Independence War is kinda in favor of Aegon right now. But the Old Wick Independence War is in favor of Old Wick. Aegon hasn't actually had any men over here, and we haven't had any men over to him, so that's probably why it's kind of neutral. And in our Lieges War, which will be you, you're kind of losing that war, and you're definitely... oh, you're actually kind of winning the other war. in the invasion of the Iron Isles because they can't figure out how to use boats. Rogar Benson died stillborn. Okay. Cool. Right. I'll just let time move on. Scourge has been released from Lady Sylvia the Fat's dungeon. Harrenhal founded the Crown Laurelis faction. Unsurprising, really, given he put them in charge. A daughter was born to Garen Ladybright and Esgrid Winch named Sylvia. Sylvia Ladybright. Okay. Although he's not in our court anymore. Right. Yes, of course, he moved to another court to be spymaster. My liege, I've tried to make Lord Will of Ironholt realize what a benevolent and peaceful ruler you really are, but sinister forces at his court have been hard at work to discredit my every move and distort my every word. I'm afraid that in the end, this visit seems to have done more harm than good. Your humble justicar, Lannis Hasterton. That reminds me. In packs, we should definitely secure the alliance pact with our brother-in-law. Negotiate non-aggression. That's not what I want. Maybe it is what I want. He just doesn't like us, and that's why he wouldn't do it. We could form a non-aggression pact. Not formally. Must not be in prison. Must not be at war. He just doesn't want it. Okay. I was thinking we could maybe get an alliance because our husband was his brother-in-law, but we can't. Okay, fine. Sir Saren Roxton has been released from Merlin Hunter's dungeons. I was looking at this battle here, which looks like the Lannisters won. Okay. Lord Victor of Golden Grove has usurped the lordship of Inchfield from Sir Hyle Merriweather. Okay. So that's Golden Grove has taken over an extra thing because his title was taken by Mern the Gardener. Mern Gardener, not Mern the Gardener. Okay, Aegon's Wars. Definitely going more in favor of the other side right now. Harwin Hoare has called in a favor on Harlan Hoare. Okay. Lord Manfred has voted for shifted noble stuff, tax law, basically. 13,000 troops who are going to stay the hell away from our province. King Aegon of Westeros accepted Storm King Criston of the Stormlands peace offer. So that's now Maesie Hook is now underneath the control of the Stormlands. Okay, cool. Is this Maesie Hook or is this Maesie Hook? I don't know. It's somewhere around here. That's Blackwater. That Maesie Hook? I don't know. We'll find out eventually. Someone will tell me, I'm sure. But either way, it's no longer under Aegon's control. Which is actually interesting because now Aegon has a good chance of winning these other wars. Because he's got a large amount of war score in favor in the Ironland Independence War. And, oh, that wasn't the one I was looking for. And in the Old Wick War, it's in favor of Old Wick right now. So Old Wick might be independent, but the Iron Islanders look like they won't be. Although they might all be under control of the Rock anyway, so who knows? The Neck War for Brandon's claim on the North has ended. White Peace. Okay. So, yeah, they're just kind of at peace. All right. Cool. The alliance between Master Donner and King Torrhen is broken down. Sir Martin Potter has been released from King Merrin the Hunter's dungeons. The Raven has arrived from the Citadel. We should prepare as winter is coming. Upon the conclusion of a long council meeting, you decided to make a toast. Of course, one toast eventually becomes many and time seems to slip away. Later, as you leave the council chamber, you stumble and fall on your face. You can feel the blood in your mouth and the dizziness setting in. We can either shout for help or we can not try and draw attention to ourselves. Well, I think we would shout for help. Definitely. Yeah, there's no reason why we wouldn't shout for help. I mean, unless we were just being arbitrary, but that's fine. Help. You hear the voice of Lord Manfred just before you pass out. As you wake up the next morning, it feels as if your head is about to explode, but at least you're safe. I'm in debt to Lord Manfred. Interesting. Now that's not something I'm happy about. He has a favor with us. He could do anything with that. He could make us change tax law. Oh, I don't know. He could also force somebody into a marriage, which is something I'm not happy with, but we'll see if we can avoid that. By calling in a favor, Lord Manfred has forced you to start a vote on the diplomatic committee law in the Wait, that's not us. It is a Lord Manfred, but it's not our Lord Manfred. Okay. But yeah, he could force us to start a vote on a law, which could be interesting. Justin Benson called in a favor of Dying Old Fire. Probably to join a plot. How are our plots looking? We have no known plots. Do we have someone actually scheming? We do have someone scheming, but we just don't have any known plots. I see. At age 71, King Mern the Ninth of the Reach died of gonorrhea. I originally read that wrong. I thought that it said goodness for some reason in my head, and that was why I had a little pause. I was like, what the hell? It's gonorrhea. I don't know how I misread that. Anyway, King Edmund is now in charge. He's 53. He already has old man face, but he is a craven. He is a mastermind scholar as well, which is interesting. People are changing, are doing votes and things. Anything that we need to be looking at right now? I mean, our son has his education focus, but our other two children do not. Like, our childhood focus. I guess we would have them both tutored in etiquette. Left we're doing it in thrift. Artisans and merchants, probably not. Guards and retainers. Humility, tutored by servants at court. I don't know, maybe we would do duty. I don't know, what would we be thinking? What would we want them to be? Maybe thrift is a good one, because we're kind of greedy. We'd want them to be like that. Like, we want them to be good with money. Yeah, possibly. Or chiefly being left to her own devices and competing with other children. That could also be it. If we're just slothful, maybe we just let them struggle. We just leave them to their own devices and let them be loosely tutored. Yes. Just seeing if we've got anything with this. Yeah, maybe we'll just do struggle for both of them. I guess that kind of makes sense. Like, we focus on one child, but the other ones are just, you know, they're just there. We'll both go for struggle. Cool. Right, so let's continue. Aegon's Ridge has founded Lord Harris for Westeros faction. Cool. How's Aegon's wars going? He has 30. This is in 30% in favor of Aegon, and that's almost Oldwick's almost got all of that. My lady, thank you for having me in your household these past years, but I must serve a higher purpose. Lord Reaver Vikrin has set me to its service, and I shall leave for Pike immediately. Yours, Barristan. He's now Spymaster in Pike, so Lady Bright now no longer has his title. How is your war against the Lannisters going? Oh, we could just check here. Yeah, it's 15% in favor of the Lannisters. Your treasurer comes to see you one afternoon. He explains he has devised a plan to bring in exotic goods by setting up a trade route with a foreign realm. This would, of course, require a sizable monetary investment, but the potential profits would also be great. I think we're going to do it. Exotic goods could be us getting fashionable silks in. Greedy, there's still a chance we make money off of it. I think this is fine. We'll organize an expedition. The time has come to outfit a ship for our trading expedition. The harbor master shows you a large ship with a sizable cargo hold that would be perfect for the job, but it does come at quite a hefty price. You know what? We'll hire a crew of bandits to try and steal the ship. Word has spread that you're planning a trading expedition, and has arrived at your court with a request. They're offering temple funds for the journey if you allow them to come along. Well, of course, they're giving us money. What could go wrong? Obviously. It's time to set out on a trading expedition. Hopefully it will yield good profits to foreign lands. The drowned mans have been giving the crew nervous glares for a couple of days now, and today confronted you, but voicing concerns about traveling with thieves and bandits. They say that the drowned god faithful should not consort with such people. Really? Uh-huh. Well, that's a bit of a double standard. The expedition finally reaches the realms of Lord Marquello Zobridra. Which is in Mantaris, which is all the way over there. Wow, we went a long way. Okay. We're getting really exotic goods. He's a Valyrian. Your treasurer asks you what gift we shall bring forth as a token of friendship to Lord Marquello. My courtesy shall be enough of a gift. At dinner, you notice Lord Marquello the Cruel's face growing red with annoyance as he glares at your steward, shuffling your food in with his bare hands. Please excuse him, I'm trying to raise this street urchin to a civilized life, or I'm hungry too. Yeah, we're just going to keep eating. We're gluttonous. You're walking idly around the court of Lord Marquello when you suddenly hear a discussion increasing in intensity around the corner. Turning around the corner, you surprise to see one of the drowned mans from your expedition engaging in a wild theological debate with a local noble. This could endanger the entire venture. The heretics must see the error of their ways, or this must be stopped. Yeah, we'll stop this. The negotiations between you and Lord Marquello suddenly halts when he slams his fist into the table. It seems like he no longer can stand your presence in the room. When you decide to leave, he shouts, "Indolent idler!" after you. Well, I guess that was it then. We have become bitter rivals with Lord Marquello. We're rivals with two people, aren't we? You were rivals with Malus, because we tried to kill him, and Marquello because we're really bad at business. The trade expedition was a failure. She didn't manage to close a deal for foreign goods. This is seen by failure, not only by you, but as everyone in your vicinity. At least I learned something. Yes, at least I learned something. How's our armies aren't really, like, fully strengthened, at full strength again, so we're just going to have to wait. Oh well. We can keep waiting. We are training children instead of reinforcing our levy, so that can explain it. Oh yeah, apparently, here's something I learned. This improved holding thing. If you send this person here to improve a holding, there is actually a new intrigue option you get for spending like an absurd amount of money to make your holding significantly better. Now, we could do that, but we don't have the absurd amount of money, so not going to. I just thought I'd mention it. Right. Let's continue seeing how things go. Looks like the Lannister War is pretty much almost done. Breakstone Hill ransomed somebody. Flint was released from someone's thing. Nothing else big there. Righteously imprisoned. We can righteously imprison our husband. He's trying to kill Meredith Lytton. I think we might do something about that. Well, we could not care less about justice. I mean, actually, we do like our husband. Presumably. Well, how much do we like him? My opinion of him is actually not that high. Can I see why? I just don't really like him, I guess. He is arbitrary as well, I guess. I mean, we could imprison him anyway. It's arbitrary, so we can actually just choose what we like. Sure. We don't really like him. We'll just imprison. We only married him so that we could have some children. He wasn't really who we wanted to marry. We have nothing in common, apart from being arbitrary. He's a bit too zealous for my liking. We'll imprison him. He managed to avoid my guardsmen and has fled to the court of Lord Theon. Let him cower in fear. Okay, so he's ran away to another court. Fine. We'll get a bodyguard. Our bodyguard is going to be... I'm going to skip down until we get a custom one. How about Trentos? You could be our bodyguard, I suppose. Or Lenzi of the Stormcrows. Let's make it Trentos. Lenzi was something earlier. Not great reasoning. He's also better at Marshall. Like the first one. Yon the Spider founded the Liege Loyalist faction. Cool. How's Aegon's other wars going against Great Wick? Great Wick's about to win it. Okay. Cool. We still have a drowned man position open. My lady, it's come to my attention nobody has been designated regent for Saltcliff should the realm need it. Needless to say, this is a perilous position, and surely squabble and rival we will emerge for a clear leadership. I humbly petition you name me as designated regent to avoid sort of trouble. Signed, Sir Lannis of House Hasterton. Sure, we could do that. I mean, we are slothful, so we'd be like, yeah, sure, he came to us with the decision. You can do it. Whatever. I'm not bothered. The Lords of Pykov approved the institution of levy-focused noble obligations law. Perfect. No idea what that is, but also don't care. Lord Harwin the Cruel accepted King Lauren the Eagle's peace offer. That ended both the wars, because this has now ended inconclusively. Old Wick is still at war. Okay. And he usurped the Kingdom of the Iron Isles from Lord Harwin, and the Lordship of Stone Tree from Lord Reaver Edmund the Lute. Oh no, that's Harwin the Cruel usurped it, so that he still has a title, because he's still a duke level, lord level, high lord level. Lord Pike usurped the lordship of Lordsport. Lord Reaver Victor Pike usurped the lordship of Lordsport from Master Yon the Spider. What a the lordship of Lordsport. Okay, so he lost his title there. Oh, interesting. Wow. So we are now still directly underneath him, but he only controls Lordsport. Because Lauren the Eagle directly took the other bit of land. I see. He is now directly under Lauren the Eagle. and we are directly underneath him. Okay, that's interesting. We'll see how that goes. All hail is Grace, Lauren of House Lannister, King of Salt and Rock, Son of Sea Wind, Lord Reaper of Castle Rock, and Protector of the Iron Isles. I think we're being a curse's name thing. He is a different religion and just literally conquered us, so curse his name. Lord Reaver Vicwin of Pike founded the Lord Harwin for the Iron Isles faction. Okay. Everything seems to be alright. Lord Edwin Lude founded the Lord Harwin for the Iron Isles faction. Seems it would be better if they worked together. There's no medium realm authority law. Oh, are we allowed to loot? I want to just check that here. We were to say raise our men. No looting allowed. Okay. Cool. Lyra has been released from King Kyle's dungeons. How is your war going, Aegon? Lord Theon of Great Wick is likely to win it, so he'll be the only independent Iron Islander. It's been brought to your attention that the Lord Guardian outside your castle is, frankly, a mess. Last week, one of your courtiers got lost in the wilderness, and the man did not emerge for 2 days. Tackling this garden problem head-on could be an excellent project for which to improve your stewardship. Suppose we are fashionable, so maybe we would want a fashionable garden? Yeah, okay. Time to stretch those, although that would also involve direct work. So no, gardening is for weak. We came in this for the money. These quick, easy business schemes that give us money. That's what we came into this for. A daughter was born to Pete and Gwyneth named Jean. Or Jean? Okay. Fine. Jenny. Could also be a way of saying it. Elia died a natural death. She was previously married to Nymor Martell and is the mother of Prince Lewin of Dorne. Lords of the Iron Isles approved the institution of the High Realm Authority Law. Oh, so what's High Realm Authority authority do? Iron Isles. High Realm Authority. Well, this one means that we are obligated to end internal wars of aggression when commanded by their liege. This one means that I guess we can't declare wars on our own. Yeah, and then Max means that we cannot declare neutrality or act independently in wars, like, of larger wars. Okay. 1st of January. It is saved. Rhaenys Targaryen is dead. She died of gonorrhea. And now, I think this is a good point to end the episode. Thank you for watching. Next time, we'll see how we do underneath the rock. See you then.